The rolling blackouts that left approximately 28,000 homes from Whangarei to Wellington without power on Monday night is continuing to generate heat in the electricity market. As we've already covered on Breakfast, various players in the sector, including generators, line companies and the grid operator, have blamed each other for the power cuts. Now, two of the smaller companies, Electric Kiwi and Haas Energy Trading, have laid official complaints about the conduct of two of the largest players, Genesis and Contact. Joining us to explain why and how he believes what happened on Monday illustrates major issues in our electricity market is Luke Blincoe, Chief Executive of independent power retailer Electric Kiwi. Morena.
Luke,
it's wonderful to have you with us. So you filed a complaint to the Electricity Authority stating undesirable trading situation. That's what occurred on Monday night. So can you break down the technicality of that?
Sure.
So I know you're essentially talking about a failure in the market. So what does that mean?
Yep. So the undesirable trading situation is, a mechanism where an event occurs that can undermine confidence in the electricity market. And I think we can all probably agree that's occurred. The reason for lodging the claim is to ensure that there's a really transparent process of investigating what's gone on. And we think that the event was caused by the generators failing to generate with plant that they did have available or should have had available.
Right, okay. But there are certain provisions when it comes to the high standard of trading conduct that players are supposed to adhere to here in the market. And you're talking about Contact Energy and Genesis.
Yep.
What exactly are the provisions that they've breached?
The provisions really require them to offer their generation to the market as if they didn't have market power. And we believe that the way they've offered their plant to the market was in a way in which they did demonstrate market power or abuse market power.
Okay, so basically to break that down, that's what they did say. We have a responsibility to our customers and we provided them, we met that supply for our customers, but at the cost of other New Zealanders who needed power at the same time that night. You're saying that's not good enough?
It's absolutely not good enough. They have an obligation to supply the market. That's what generators do. The reference to supplying their own customers is just, I think, shining a light on the vertical integration issue that we've got, where we've got companies that both generate and retail, and the signals start to get quite mixed and become distorted.
Right.
The irony is that they didn't successfully supply their own customers, did they?
No, right. This is where the saga has been heating up all week. We've got Transpower, who's saying if there'd been enough power in the system, Monday night's incident never would have happened. Contact Genesis Energy boss Mark England says he didn't get enough warning to ramp up his extra power station at Huntly. After Transpower said that, Contact Energy saying that we generated as much power as we could, and with Transpower saying if there was enough power, it never would have happened. Other power companies are saying, well, that's just not true. It kind of reminds me a little bit of my kids. I've got four kids, and when something, if they've stuffed up, they're standing there in front of me shifting the blame. But essentially, how much damage do you think this has done to public confidence, public trust in the electricity market?
Yeah, look, you hit the nail on the head. All this finger pointing is kind of the reason for filing a UTS, to actually shine some light on this issue. Let's have a transparent view of what's gone on. But in terms of confidence in the market, it was pretty low already. We've, as a nation, been paying through the eyeballs for electricity already, and now we've also got to worry about security of supply. And it fundamentally comes down to market structure, that the vertically integrated players, those that generate and retail, have incentives to always force the wholesale price as high as they can to make the most money.
So there is the issue of price and there is the issue of supply, both of which you've said here. And you yourself, I understand your company, Electric Kiwi, is no longer seeking new customers. You're not the only company doing that. Why is that?
We can't, purchase hedge contracts or cover in order to be able to supply customers at the current retail market prices. So over the last 5 years, we've been the fastest growing retailer in New Zealand. Now we're not growing at all. And fundamentally what that means, and I guess the role of independent retailers like us, is we've always been the price leaders in the market. We set the price and we create the downward pressure to keep the big guys honest. When we stop growing and we remove ourselves from comparison sites like PowerSwitch, there's no longer any downward pressure on price. There is no competition in the retail market now. There's options, but there's no price competition. And that's fundamentally another, symptom of the failed market.
And interesting enough, power switch is actually something the Electricity Authority has encouraged New Zealanders to use to try and find, every 6 months, check on what is the best deal that you're getting. But companies like yourselves are pulling out of that.
Yes. Yep. In fact, they're currently advertising people to go there, but actually the competition's not there. The independents like ourselves, can't play in this market, and that's fundamentally because of the way that the market's structured and the incentives for the generators to maximise wholesale prices.
So you've obviously got some skin in the game. We do have to say that.
But absolutely.
What do you say to viewers who say, well, maybe he's just miffed that he can't play with the big boys?
Oh, look, all we've ever asked for is a level playing field. We've never asked for a handout or a leg up. What we want is a level playing field, and we back ourselves to win. We've been winning for the last 5 years. We think we've probably got the lowest overhead structure in the industry. We're the leanest operation. We just want a level playing field, and we'll have at it. So, no handouts required here. We've got a really successful company, and we're actually doing really, really well in Australia. We'd just like to be able to be doing well at home.
The Energy Minister has also pointed to low lake levels, gas supply issues as the reason for some of the high power prices. But essentially, is there some structural reform that's needed here to this market?
Absolutely. Structural reform is the only solution that's going to provide any sort of sustainable relief for Kiwi consumers. So what I mean by that is breaking up the generators, so splitting off their retail and generation businesses, and probably breaking up Meridian into a couple of smaller generating units to create more tension in the generation part of the market.
And how difficult do you think that will be to be able to get some of these big players to share some of those power generators?
Thankfully, the government still owns 51% of three of them, so I think there's a pretty easy avenue there. And recently, I think we've seen a couple of really good precedents that demonstrate how straightforward it is. We've seen Trustpower sell off their retail business. It took them less than 6 months with no urgency. So it's not that hard. We've also seen a really good example in the telecommunications industry when the government split up Telecom into Spark and Chorus, and consumers haven't looked back since then, have they?
Yeah, no, that's actually a good example to point to of that industry. But we thank you so much for your time. Luke Blincoe,
thanks for having me.
Chief Executive of Electric Kiwi.
Thank you.